So you want to brag about tracing your history back to the kings and the royalty of Europe? Well, I got you beat. Through DNA, I can have my ancestry traced back to the cavemen. Howdy, I'm Andy Lee with Family History Fanatics, and this is a segment of DNA. If you've tested through 23andMe, one of the things that you can find out is how much Neanderthal DNA you have. Now, research in the last 10 years has shown that humans who have ancestry outside of Africa have a small percentage of Neanderthal DNA. And what that means is that tens of thousands of years ago, modern humans, us, and Neanderthals interbred somewhere in either the Middle East or the Caucasus Mountains, and their descendants also then spread throughout the rest of the world. And with them came some bits of Neanderthal DNA that's been preserved down through the generations to you and me. You can find this on 23andMe by going to your ancestry reports and looking at the Neanderthal variants and how much you have. Now, this isn't a whole lot. For instance, I have 292 variants of the Neanderthal DNA, and that's out of the 900,000 SNPs that 23andMe has looked at. 23andMe used to give you an actual percentage estimate of how much Neanderthal DNA you have, and I remember mine was around 2.7%. You can also go and look at your distribution of your Neanderthal variants over your entire genome, and you can see here that mine has Neanderthal DNA throughout almost all of my chromosomes, except for chromosome number 21 and my X and my Y chromosome. Now, most of these Neanderthal variants are in non-coding regions of your DNA, so they actually don't affect anything in how your life is. But there are a handful of them that are related to traits or actually on certain genes. For instance, there's a couple that code for height, one that codes for the amount of back hair that you have, and most peculiarly, there's one that has to do with whether or not you sneeze after eating dark chocolate, which I find absolutely fascinating because chocolate is native to the Americas and there were no Neanderthals in the Americas. So I'm curious how evolution got a reaction for one organism, Neanderthals, to another organism, chocolate, the cocoa plant, even though those two organisms never had any interaction whatsoever. And how that variant has been passed down now to humans today. That is just an amazing part of how genetics works that I'd like to know more about myself. Now, as you're looking into your Neanderthal DNA, it's not going to help you build your ancestral tree at all. It is really there for your fun, for your enjoyment, to learn something a little bit more about science. How much Neanderthal DNA you have really doesn't have much of a bearing on how you're related to other people, and you're not going to be able to use that to make connections in any way. But it can give you bragging rights. For instance, the kings of Europe were only about 500 years ago, whereas your caveman ancestors, that's tens of thousands of years ago. And tens of thousands of years is far better than just knowing who somebody was 500 years ago. And my wife actually has more Neanderthal DNA than I do. So I married a cavewoman.
If you like this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up so that it can reach more viewers. Connect with us on Twitter at FH Fanatics or on Facebook, Family History Fanatics, where we can interact with you and respond to your comments.